Hey, what's up, guys? Hope you've been well. I'm here in my garage. It's kind of a wreck. I'm still kind of moving in. But anyway, there's a video I wanted to make real quick. I'm kind of starting to pack up for this trip I'm going on this weekend. And it's all about the rack system that I use on my Diamondback truck cover. If you've watched my channel for any amount of time, you know that I love this. Probably my favorite mod to date. Can't live without it. I'll link it down below. If you have questions about it, you can give them a call. They have great customer service as well. And just let them know you're looking for a setup like Last Line of Defense and they'll be able to get you taken care of. Speaking of Front Runner, also, this isn't something I can link to because it's kind of a custom setup. So if you call them, they also have amazing customer service. They will be able to help you out. Just say, I'm looking for a setup, Last Line of Defense, use it on Diamondback. They'll know exactly what you're talking about. Great company. They make rack systems for the roof and all kinds of other stuff as well. I'm only using them right now back here because I've kind of just recently got into their ecosystem, which is incredible. This video is not going to be about their ecosystem, but it is, they have like accessories for everything you could imagine. This is just going to be about the Diamondback truck cover system. So I've used a bunch of different racks on this. I've broken some. Some have been okay. Some haven't been perfect. This, I think, is about the perfect setup for how I have it set up. So I kind of have like a mid-height bed system where I have the iCamper tent right now, the X cover. I think this is still on pre-sale, where it's about flush with my top racks. I love this setup. It gives me just shy of 8 inches of clearance here, which means I can still mount my Pelican cases like these ones. So those can still slide under here, or you can slide tables or cornhole sets or whatever you want under here. So I like the versatility of having the space kind of underneath the tent. And then we obviously have all the storage space in here. I just got this bag. My friend Philip he's crazy about these bags. He said, I need one. Just bought it. Just came. It's a pretty cool color. I'll link to it down below. Okay. So the track system, this is kind of what makes this unique. If you remember previously, I had two bars here and here. Those I spaced out to mount my Max Tracks with their mounting pins that are lockable and nice. I have these Max Tracks mounted up high, kind of in line, nice. When I need them, I can just pull them off really easy. They don't take up any storage space. And you know, they look cool and overlandy. I made these like super ghetto, kind of proof of concept mounts, these little brackets, bent them and put them in. This was kind of proof of concept, but they're permanent for now until I have the energy to do something. Sorry, I'm having some trouble focusing here. I'm at a weird angle. So let's talk about the system. What you'll get is two of these tracks, one for this side, obviously, and one for that side. We'll get to in a second. You do have to cut them in the middle. That's why this kind of, they would like to talk to you on the phone to kind of explain it to you, but I'll explain it to you a little bit here. And then you'll get your slats or your crossbars. They do sell these in various lengths. They do sell these in various heights. So if you want exactly what I have on the Tacoma, just tell them that's what you want. If you want some longer ones or some shorter ones, then you can do that. But anyways, these will bolt into here with these little feet that slide in here. What that means is you can slide this back and forth. I had two. I needed to keep them spaced. They were further back. I have this long tent that overhangs. I didn't like it. I either could have moved these two back and then my Max Tracks would have been overhanging, or I could have moved these forward and got a third bar, which is what I did here, obviously. I wouldn't have been able to do that with another system because I would have had to drill more holes and I would have been screwed into this and I would have had to perfectly line these up so the Max Tracks fit in. Anyways, this made it a breeze, adding a third bar all the way back to give it the support that I needed. Now the Front Runner ecosystem, which I'm not really using any of them, allows all kinds of accessories. I mean, just go to their website, they have an accessory for everything. So for you gearheads out there, really, really awesome stuff. The core of the Front Runner system are the slats. They have these little cutouts on the top and the bottom, which will obviously allow you to drop bolts in. They do sell these as well. I think they're M8s. And you drop these in, and then you can slide them around, tighten them down, and have little tie-down points everywhere. They have the same thing on the bottom as well. So I do have like these on the bottom for tie-down points, just kind of always. So you see, this is the track system. You have to cut it And then it's aluminum. I just painted it black. You don't really need to, but just for looks. Aluminum is nice, won't rust, won't corrode or anything like that. You will have enough left over for a piece here if you want to. So you could put a bar here. The guy that kind of turned me onto this, on Tacoma World, he had his system here where the whole rack was here and there, and he had like the cage, and he could still open the front. That was really cool. I didn't really have any intention to do that, so I haven't mounted this piece here, but you can mount another piece here and put a tower and a bar if you want to. Again, you can get these track systems in different lengths. So I think the Tacoma one is one of the shorter ones, or maybe the shortest one. But anyways, again, give them a call, tell them what you're looking for. They'll be able to take care of you. The modularity of the front runner system is both the slat system, but also they have like an exterior kind of ring around it for their roof rack systems. I don't have that. I kind of want to get into it just because it's so cool, and I kind of want to capitalize on some of those accessories, but I haven't yet. But anyways, that's pretty much the system. Super modular, very awesome. Actually, while we're here, look at this. So this is the iCamper mounts that are really slick. These are the new ones. But this goes in here. Sorry, kind of hard to do one-handed. But this will go into here. This will screw in, and then once it gets tight, there's just a hex or an Allen head that you just screw it, tighten it on, clamp it up. Four of those incredible mount system, my favorite mount system on a tent. Actually, Front Runner actually makes a quick disconnect, which is probably a sweeter setup. I don't have that. But anyways, this is a really cool mounting system for the iCamper, which I'm using. So these bars, super awesome. I am very happy with the setup. If you've kind of followed along on my journey, you know that I've had some heartache over some various rack systems that I've used on this. Very happy with the Front Runner system. And again, great dudes over there, great customer service, and just a really, really high quality product. Works great, great on the Diamondback cover, which I still can't imagine living without. Okay guys, that's it. Sorry this video is really random, but I've been getting so many questions about the rack system that I figured I would just throw a quick video together so that way I can point everyone to it that's asking me questions. Again, if something changes and I can link to like the system, I will update the links down below. I'll link to Front Runner. You can check them out. But if you want this system, you gotta call in, just let them know. Last Line of Defense or Diamondback or whatever, and they'll be able to get you squared away. You could use a system like this on top of like a topper, like a truck topper or anything that's flat that you can mount a track on. So not just for the Diamondback, but really pairs nicely with the Diamondback. All right, oh, stay tuned. Actually, I don't know when I'll release this video. It'll probably be quick and I'll probably edit it, but I'm gonna be going on a trip this weekend. I'll link to the dudes I'm going with down below, but follow along on our journey. It's gonna be really fun. We're heading out to Utah. We're gonna be making a bunch of content. It's gonna be a great time. So stay tuned for that. And until next time, take care.